Welcome back to Shay Say. If you do not know, I am Marche. I am the creator and founder of Shay Say, which is my personal brand. So today I wanted to just come back and talk to you guys because it's my anniversary of officially being a business for 1 year. I officially turned my hobby into a business on July 1st, 2020, right here in this room, which is my office. Right now, everything is still like at the beginning stages. So through this video, I just want to take you through my first year's journey of just how I made this into a business and really just the journey of learning. So let's go. Okay, so I started my personal brand, Shay Say, 2 years ago, back in 2019. I started it when I had went to a technical like trade college here called the Ohio Media School, which there I had found my passion and like my purpose, which was blogging, editing, and just creating content. Shay Say, I have a video on my page. It's like at the bottom, one of my first few videos of like where Shay Say actually came from. I will link it below or on the screen here. But so that's how Shay Say got started. I was at the Ohio Media School and we had took a blogging like block. They were like block periods, so like courses, I guess. And I've always been a writer. I run from things in my life that I know I'm supposed to be like doing. So I've always been a writer. I was a lazy kid. Cause you know, writing, you can't just like write something and send it out. Like there's an editing process with everything. But I found that with my blog, I took it really serious. And it's like with natural talent, you have to develop your skill, to which I'm still doing. I'm still working on the writing end of things. So I'm kind of like still running in a sense. But that was the first piece to Shay Say. I found that I enjoyed editing in that program when we would have to like make audio commercials. And I tell everybody, like, I could be in the studio, kid you not, for 8 hours and zone out, but it would feel as if I've only been in there for like maybe 2 hours or so. So with that, that's how I knew like that was my passion. When people ask you what is something that if you didn't get paid to do it, you would still do it for free, I would just say editing, like creating content and editing. Towards the end of the program, which was like 8 months in total, I learned how to edit videos within the last week. I always say, I may have mentioned this like in another video, but I always say like, I was absent for all of my video courses. They put me on the camera as talent, because they just felt my face was suited for camera. But when it actually came to editing and putting everything together, I kid you not, I was absent from all of it. I will explain my journey with that program more in depth too. But I figured, I'm a fast learner. I had help with learning how to edit. But I learned, it's the same as audio editing, it's just visual. There's still things I don't know. So that's how Shay Say, my personal brand, is actually been around for 2 years. But for me, actually taking a hobby and becoming serious about it and making it a business and running things as a business, it's been 1 year officially. So the first step that I did to figure out how to turn my hobby into a business was I knew I needed to figure out how to, I've always heard about like LLCs, and I live in Ohio, so wherever you are, do your research pertaining to your state, because every state is not the same and there's still things that I'm learning. So I went to my Secretary of State website, and I just also did like other research. There's things where people tell you like you can pay somebody to do it. If you want the conveniency and you have the budget and you really don't have the time to pay somebody, you can. But here in Ohio, to form a LLC, it's $100. I'm just a very independent person. I'm a researcher naturally. I was about to pay somebody almost like maybe $150 or $200 to file my business license for me. So I did my research. I figured out that an LLC works for me personally, and I filed for my business license. And with that, the turnaround period here is fairly quick. So it literally took them a day to say like, yes, the Shaysay is approved to work as a business in Ohio. So after I did that, and always organization, when you are just running a business, starting out just in life, it's key to be organized, because you want to hold on to all of your important documents. So as soon as I do anything, I save everything to my computer, I email it to myself, and I save it to like my files. Just having multiple files of one thing, because you can't rely on just one piece of technology. Anything can fail, you know. So after I did that, I then went to the IRS, so www.irs.gov, and I filed for my EIN number, or your entity number. And with that, if you hear people say like that's your social security number for your business, so that's how you're able to open up like business checking accounts. That's how you're able to get business credit cards, get a lot of things under like your business name. So it's really as if having your personal social security number is just for your business. So then after I did that, that process also only took not even a day. Like that was instant, honestly, according to my memory. That was very, very instant. So in the process of me also doing both filing my business license and also obtaining my EIN number, I also was working on my website. I'm one of those people, like, I don't give credit to myself, but I do. I sat here in this room and I worked on my website. I designed it by myself. I used the Wix template. Now, it took me a month. When I was just procrastinating. It doesn't take that long, like if you really just sit down and do it in one setting. But I worked on my professional website in the midst of putting all the other pieces together, because it's like right now in the age that we live in, I know for me personally, when someone says that they have a business or X, Y, and Z, I'm looking outside of your social media page. I'm also looking for a website to see how legitimate you are. And also just for me personally, when someone has a website, it shows that they're actually taking what they're doing serious. So it makes me become like more in tune to see what you have going on. So I highly recommend having a website. If you don't have the time or just the means, or you just, that's not your area to create a website, I would consider reaching out or finding like whatever is in your budget for someone to create a website. Like when you really hear people say it takes nothing initially to start a business, like under $500, really under $300, it takes nothing. But let me backtrack. Before you work on your website, or maybe as you're working, it depends on you, make sure that your domain name is not already taken. And I actually should have said this at the beginning. Even your business name, make sure that there is no other name that is operating with that same name. And also, if you have a logo, your name, any sayings, look into getting that trademarked as well. That's just extra protection, because without the trademarking, it's basically up for grabs for anybody. And if you ever took something to court, possibly, it just may be a little hard to prove, in a sense. So protect yourself first. That's the one thing I can just say, is protect you and your business first. Whatever you do, keep that at the forefront of your mind to always protect your business. Also, to be a business person, I'm going to get back to my point, you kind of have to have some type of shrewdness in you. That's not you being mean, that's not you being an a-hole. You just have to know when to play hard, or just be a little bit more assertive when it comes to certain things. Anyhow, back to the point. So yeah, back to the website. So I also created my website, and I wanted to make sure that for my website, I had, like, you know, videos, blogs. I wanted to just make sure everything flows. It is kind of, it's time consuming, honestly, because, like, with Wix, I had to not only view it in, like, desktop view, but I also had to make sure everything came together smoothly and cohesively in mobile view. And some of the things that may have been on desktop view, just wouldn't fit or work with the mobile view as well. So nothing in life is ever smooth sailing. Nothing in life that you want comes easy. And we also live in a world where everybody wants instant gratification, and I will always admit that I have felt victim to wanting instant, like, success and everything. So once again, I've been officially a business for a full year, but I've been doing my own thing for 2 years. Everything starts with dedication, discipline, and consistency. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I've had my moments where I would be really consistent, and then I may take like a week to a month off, and I wouldn't make videos, I wouldn't send out emails to those who subscribe to my email list. And I would sit there in my room or just whatever, kind of down, like, well, why haven't my videos or my blog been picked up yet? Why aren't people watching it? You know, but then I was like, Marsha, you can't get mad, because you yourself, you're not consistent with your content. And consistency goes from putting out content, promotion, reaching out to people genuinely. And also posting on your Instagram and having, like, in a sense, your theme. Like, what's your theme? Like, this is my theme. Any, like, if you go on my social media page, you'll see a lot of, like, just yellow and gold. I like gold jewelry. Like, that's because that's who I am as a person. Now, for my social media, I don't want, like, a overly curated page filled with images. But it's like the consistent images that you will see is blonde hair and a lot of gold or yellow. Uh-oh, y'all see that? Anyways, but you'll see a lot of gold and like yellow tones in my picture and everything. I've also learned to really just focus on what I'm doing, making sure that I am staying true to who Marsha is, being authentic. That is another reason at times that I would take maybe like a week or so off, because I would just feel, especially when I was looking like on Instagram very heavy, like scrolling, I'm not easily influenced, but we still, as just people naturally, we pick up on, we pick and we take from other people. So we'll pick up little habits or like just little things, little phrases. So I had to just make sure that before I ever made a video, I was being like a true, authentic me, giving everybody like who Marche is and not who I'm trying to like conform to of what the world thinks that I should like be in a sense and everything. But I also, in this journey, I'm very proud of myself. In a sense, I am the only person in my family that is doing something I truly like enjoy, and that's no slight to like nobody, but it's like I'm kind of like the first person that's breaking the mold of the regular routine where you graduate high school, you go to college or something, or you just work and everything. I tell everybody, like my saying is, I am my own blueprint. I don't have like a guide to show me. I mean, I watch like different videos of other people, but I'm really out here doing it on my own. I got to the point too, like recently, where I'm like, you know what, you're about to be 26 this year. You slacked off a lot. You weren't consistent. You keep saying you don't like that your life is like this, or you don't feel that your business is growing. So now I came back like even harder. I am becoming like more disciplined. I'm taking my business 10 times more serious, because it's also like, to be legitimate, I want to be a credible and legitimate business. Well, I am. I'm not going to say I want to be. But you also have to develop your skills even more. So like now I'm taking a time where I find courses to develop like my marketing skills, my writing skills, my graphic design skills. I'm not a one-dimensional person. I have a lot that I want to offer to you guys, but it's like I can't be good to y'all if I don't invest in myself first. And so I am proud of myself, because with my personal brand, that's a big investment into me personally. And I'm just looking forward to see what this next year brings. And I am looking forward to growth as well. Before I go, I will say too, one thing I definitely learned, because I'm such like a go the opposite direction of the crowd. But in business, at times, the one tip I will always remind you all of is that you have to play the game. So like when TikTok came out, I'm not a big TikTok person, but then Instagram developed Reels, I kept posting IGTV videos. I'm a very small page. Those videos, I wasn't reaching outside of my already like made audience or followers. But I realized once I start posting Reels, i.e. playing the game, I got a lot more views. And also, with my first Instagram page, just like a little tip, like little tip, free tip, I had deleted my old page because it was just filled with people. I wasn't really connected with people. I hadn't talked to in years, and I went through like, you know, I'm actually like a more so private person, so my mindset was kind of like, I don't really like, if I haven't talked to you in the past year or so, I don't like, what am I looking at your life for, whatever. So when I had deleted that page to make a whole new page. My old page, I probably had maybe like 1,000 to 3,000 followers, and I was always like scrolling, deleting. My new page, I started back with 200, and I was getting frustrated because I'm like, well, dang, my old page got, they do change the algorithm too, but also I was like, my old page, I had like a lot of views, I was getting like more reach and everything. And then with this new page, I'm not getting half as many views. And then I'm kind of like a patterns type person, So whatever your like following is, your engagement will always be average, like 10% of that. So then it clicked. I have like, I'm the type where I have to talk my problems out for me to come up with my solutions. So I was talking it out and it was like, duh, I have to, it's like networking, but like virtual networking. You have to put, as an entrepreneur, business person, like especially when you're unknown, you had to put yourself in people's faces first. So I was like, duh, I have to expand my virtual network. I have to, even though I might not want to for the sake of my business, and it is genuine because I don't follow people that I don't care about or like whose content I'm not interested in, but I'm like, I have to follow more people. And I started engaging with other pages, and I followed them and they followed me back. And it's not like just a follow for follow, like I actually follow, I engage with the pages, and it's like, okay, my brain is working. So that's just one little like tip I give you. Like, you just have to play the game to win the game. It's like they say, until people know your name without you introducing it, you have to introduce yourself first. So I thank you all for once again just staying with me and rocking with me, especially for those who've been with me from the beginning. You guys don't understand how much I really, really do just appreciate your support, honestly. I'm just really looking forward to see what this next year holds. This background will always be like this, but you know, when you start from the beginning, you make it do with what you got. Like, you can't ask God for more if you don't work with what He's giving you. So I love you all, and I'll see you soon.